Tipbox Talks. We're here at the Cancer Metabolism 2018 talk by Abcam to talk to people about reproducibility in science.
Let's go.
Have you heard of the reproducibility crisis?
Yes.
I haven't.
No.
So I think it's a major concern, especially because nowadays that science is going to be internationalized even more. There's going to be this network, worldwide network. So it's critical to be able to reproduce, of course.
Yes. Okay, great. Okay.
About antibodies?
Across the whole thing. Yeah.
I was taken back by your use of the term crisis. The complexity of doing research makes some types of findings more difficult to reproduce than others.
I've heard some stories and things that went wrong in terms of reproducing. I know a little bit about it. I have never experienced it.
Do you have any experiences of your own of trying to reproduce data or struggling to reproduce data?
Yeah, there was a paper, only one paper published on a particular phosphorylation site that required a specific antibody, and we tried to reproduce it and weren't able to.
Okay.
We noticed that several other labs around the world were not able to reproduce our results because they use different antibodies or just didn't do an optimization of the protocol that was needed.
So Nature did a quick survey of 1,500 people and showed that 50% of scientists have failed to reproduce their own experiments and 70% have failed to reproduce a published experiment. What would you say was most likely the biggest cause of this lack of reproducibility? Because there are a range of options, but if you had to put something at the top two, what do you reckon that would be?
Some types of experiments are more amenable to this, but I think that people need to design experiments that build in kind of durability type of analysis, like how reproducible is this in different systems. I mean, often we try to cook the system so we're finding a scenario in which we can really study something, and that is important to get down to a molecular mechanism. You need to kind of strip it down to its essence, you know.
I think it would be difficult to pinpoint it on reagents because the reproducibility crisis as such shows up in so many different with using so many different reagents. I think definitely having more detailed methods in papers would improve that.
A lot of it comes down to reagents and the people not doing the due diligence on validating the core reagents that they use.
Lacking information in the methods part.
Also sometimes just technical inexperience or technical errors that happen.
Polyclonal antibodies.
Ah, yeah.
We need a platform to share the protocols.
That would be
quite.
I think definitely having more detailed methods in papers would improve that. But I also think that, I don't know, there's a whole slew of contributing factors, one of which is our refusal as a field to accept negative data being published. And so I think if you're already skewing what kind of results you're showing, it makes sense that we're less able to reproduce them because maybe they're just a smaller fraction of what's really happening.
Database probably with standardized protocol will be able to publish more, to give more space about material in the metal section.
Also, when it gives you the reference and you go to the article, the information is actually not there.
Yeah.
Or they say that they incubated with this antibody, but they don't say if it was for 2 hours or 24 hours, and this can make a big difference.
Okay.
Recognition that journals are asking for a lot more detail now on the methods. I think that's a good thing. If it's in the supplemental text, that could be 50 pages long if needed.
I think as much as that is as education, and basically early on in graduate school and maybe even in undergraduate curriculums, but especially first-year graduate students need to be taking classes on reproducibility and rigor, and just how to experiment, what is a reproduction of an experiment, what is the N mean, what's a biological replicate versus a technical replicate, and all these things that, you know, just the core values that we all as PIs kind of take for granted. We should be directing our students towards this. They should learn this, and it should just be part of their fabric. That you need to validate your reagents. You know, you need to reproduce experiments a minimum of 3 times, and so on. So we kind of take for granted that they should know this, and they don't always. They just like oh, this one worked, and I'm going to show this one, and they have 3 experiments, only one of them worked. And
so when we're sharing protocols, it should be just like a recipe. And
so lack of standardization between protocols.
So if you do exactly the same things the same way using the same instrument, mm-hmm. and then you can't reproduce it, then there might be something else behind it.
And also from the companies to be able to have standard antibodies, of course, that may be useful to repeat all the different experiments.
Yeah. It's a big question with where do you start, but changing the incentive structure in publications, I think. I don't know at which level that has to start, but yeah, I think
something has to
change.
That's
one of the only ways.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's great.
So we are back at Abcam HQ. I think we had some really good conversations today.
We did. It was a good day. A good day had by all.
Yeah, absolutely. There was a really good push towards the need for education. Lots of people mentioned that as a young PhD student, you're just kind of thrown at the deep end, and validation is rarely something you ever cover in proper detail.
And also, it was interesting to see how much people wanted to see changes in journals. So people really wanted the materials and methods sections of journals to be changed to allow for better reproducibility of experiments.
Totally. So, and that dude that wanted the protocol platform so that we can share a detailed protocol without having to go back to the reference, who referenced the reference. You never find the actual source material.
Yeah, great
which
fun.
Which is super fun. Talk about what vendors need to be doing, whether it's knockout validation or testing multiple applications or references or mass spec or whatever, but that feeling that vendors need to be doing a lot more before the antibody even reaches them, but not just the antibody, but reagents in general.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tune in next time for more Tipbox Talks and awesome commentary from Bill and Vix.
Yeah. See you.
Bye.